And welcome to the Paint Gun Testing Initiative. You have been in hibernation for...
9, 9, 9, 9, 9.
That doesn't seem right. Well, it doesn't really matter. Please leave the restroom whenever you are ready. I know that bed might look comfy. But we've got much to do, so please exit your room. You know, I don't even know why they even bother giving you a bed. They will drag the test subjects into the stasis chambers anyways. After long periods of hibernation, the human body loses some of its strength. So, before we get to the paint gun testing, we should do some warm-up testing. Don't worry, nothing too difficult. Testing hasn't officially begun yet, so we're free to talk without anyone listening in on us. But your profile says you're not an early bird, so I understand if you don't want to talk at the moment. I was just informed that even if we are not testing yet, I am not allowed to mention anything that is mentioned in your profile. I hope they don't add this to my profile.
Hey. Please put me down.
I know this experiment will go without any problems. I can see it in you. Pick up the device and let the vacuum delivery system take us to the first test involving paint. Okay, I know you're wondering what you are holding. Don't worry, it'll all make sense as we progress. Let me see... There. Okay, just go through the door now. Alright, why don't you try firing your gun? See what happens. You solved that really fast! Now, this next chamber should offer more of a challenge for us. Very good. Nice. Okay, maybe it's time to introduce myself. I'm Nigel, and I will be your testing associate for this testing track. Glad to meet you. Test subject name here. Guess you forgot to fill that out. Don't worry, I'll get that checked. In case you haven't noticed yet, that green field, the Aperture Science Paint Gun Activation Field, also known as Fizzler, will activate and deactivate your paint gun. Expensive. So just please only spray where you think is necessary. Our Aperture Science sentient washing servos will thank you. Now this is the Advanced Jumping Training Course. It will teach you, ideally, how to navigate through future test chambers. Looks really fun. Sometimes, I wish I had legs so I could do what you do, but then I remember the other things we do to test subjects. I probably shouldn't have said that. Don't worry, I'm sure you'll be fine. I just looked at the documentation for these big monitors. Let me show you myself. Sweet, isn't it? Now you can look at me. So it's not as creepy knowing you're being watched, cause you can watch me too. How cool is that? Oh, the door. Let me get that for you. And the song. Good luck. Thank you.
You seem to be getting the hang of this. See you on the other side. Although I can see you all the time you're in the ventilatory dispatch system.
Where the fun begins, a real puzzle. You will have to use all the skills you've learned in the previous chambers. Let me put some ambient music on to get us in a good puzzle-solving mood. Good luck.
Hello. Target locked. Who are you? Hey, put me down.
You may now exit the room. Chop chop, you should be able to reach the exit rather quickly.
So, it turns out that the vacuum tube I gave you for the previous test does not connect to the next test chamber. So, we are going to have to walk for a little bit. This test chamber was for another test, which we are not assigned to. It was supposed to be solved with a portal gun. Wicked stuff. I'm sure there's a way we can solve it in our way. Done! I couldn't have done it better myself. Now, we have to find a vacuum delivery. This elevator is malfunctioning. We are looking for a vacuum delivery system. The door is rigged to open when the subject walks through the corridor. I should have probably prevented that from happening. Now this test does make use of portals as a testing element. If you've never bumped into them before, they're pretty straightforward. Thingy goes in, thingy goes out. Piece of cake. Nothing out of this world. It's time to increase the complexity just by one variable.